Hello students, today we will discuss about the introduction of human skeleton. In our previous class, we have discussed about the anatomical terminology. These terminology help us to understand the anatomical position, anatomical structure, and other studies related to anatomy. We have studied about the anatomical position, supine, prone lying position, and the directional terms associated with anatomy. The objective of our today's class is we are gonna study about the bone of the skeleton system, which are grouped in two principal divisions. The first division is axial skeleton, and the another skeleton system is appendicular skeleton. Class, first of all, we will discuss about what is skeleton. A skeleton includes the bones and the cartilage. The whole framework of bones is called as skeleton. It forms the main supporting framework of the body, which is primarily designed for more effective production of movement by the attached muscle, ligament, tendon to those bone structure. Let's take a brief introduction to bones. Bone is 1/3 connective tissue. It is impregnated with calcium salt, which constitute 2/3 part of the bone. In strength, bone is comparable to iron and steel. Despite its hardness and high calcium content, the bone is very much a living tissue. It is highly vascular. Yes, the bone is full of blood supply. It shows a characteristic pattern of growth. A bone is responsible for increasing the length of the body. It can mold itself according to change in stress and strain it bears. Yes, the bone can change the shape as it shows diffuse atrophy and overuse hypertrophy. If we cannot use a part of the bone for a long term, the bone shows atrophy, and if we use a bone for a very long time with overuse, then it also shows hypertrophy. In the human body, at birth, there are approximately 270 bones present. Many of these fuse together during development, leaving a total 260 separate bones in adults, not contouring numerous small sesamoid bone. The largest bone in the body is femur, which is a thigh bone, and the smallest is the stapes, which is present in middle ear. The bone of the skeleton system are grouped into two principal divisions. When we start studying about the different types of bone, then we get to know that bones are divided into two principal divisions. The first pattern is axial skeleton, and the second is appendicular skeleton. Today we will discuss about the axial skeleton only. Axial skeleton consists of bones that lie around the longitudinal axis of the human body. The bone of skull, the hyoid bone, ribs, sternum, and bones of the vertebral column. Mainly those bones which are associated to the middle of the body. Other than there is appendicular structure, which consists of bones of upper limb, lower limb, and the shoulder and the pelvic girdle. So here is the introduction. This is appendicular structure. The brown color, the highlighted color, is the appendicular structure. This is what we call the upper limb and the shoulder girdle, both upper limb and shoulder girdle, and pelvic girdle and the lower limb. These consist of the appendicular structure. And the axial skeleton, the skull, the facial bones, the thorax, and the spine. These all consist in axial skeleton. Let us discuss about the axial skeleton first. The bones of axial skeleton. There are different bones in the axial skeleton, which includes bones of skull. In skull, there is bones of head skeleton, bone of facial skeleton and bone of ear ossicles and one hyoid bone. These comprise the skull area. The vertebral column, which includes cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral and coccyx region and having bones in these particular areas. And the third part is thoracic cage, which includes sternum and the ribs. So, as we discussed, now the names of these bones. We have discussed that the skull is having 8 bones. There is one frontal bone. Here is the frontal bone. The one occipital bone, the posterior side, the base of skull. Ethmoid bone. Here this is ethmoid bone. Then siphenoid, parietal and temporal. This is siphenoid, this is temporal, this is occipital, this is parietal and this is frontal bone. Then facial bone. Facial bones are vomer. This is vomer bone. Mandible, the lower jaw. Maxilla, the upper jaw. Zygomatic, the cheekbone. Nasal, the nasal conchae. Lacrimal and the palatine in the mouth. In this association, there are auditory auricle bones, which are malleus, incus and stapes. These 6 bones are paired bones present in right and left ear auricles. And in additional, there is one hyoid bone. This is beneath the tongue and have not joined with any other bone. The third part is the vertebral column. It comprises a series of bones called vertebrae. There are 33 bones in birth bone baby and 26 bone in adult. 7 are cervical vertebral column. These are the uppermost 7 bones are cervical. The next 12 bones are called as thoracic. Then 5 are lumbars. Then sacrum and coccyx. The sacrum is consists of 5 fused sacral vertebral bones. And coccyx is formed by 4 fused vertebral columns. In children or young ones, these sacrum and coccyx are not fused. That's why it is 33 bones. Next is thoracic cage. The thoracic cage is comprised of 25 bones. The one is sternum, called as thigh bone, in the middle of chest bone, and there are 12 pair of ribs. The first 7 bones, which are called as true ribs, next 8, 9 and 10 are called as false ribs, and 11th and 12th pair is called as floating rib. So here the axial skeleton is completed, and here is the summary of today's presentation. The summary of today is that we have studied about the skeleton system and get to know that there is axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. We discussed about the axial skeleton and having that axial skeleton is having 3 parts. The first is bone of skull, which is having skull, facial bone and auditory auricle bones and plus one hyoid. Vertebral column, which is having cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral and coccyx. And the third part is thoracic cage, which is having sternum and ribs. These are the references for your help. I hope you will understand all this content, and if there is need to any help, you can take the reference. Thank you.